And welcome back YouTube. Alright, my recording has been updated, so I hopefully it's working because it's not giving me an overlay anymore. But let's go forward, and this time around we're gonna be taking out the... There is a base up here, I do know that. So we're gonna be taking that one out, and of course we're grabbing back our resources, 40,000 of them, and this should help us rebuild, well, build first the T2, and hopefully we're gonna end it by in a couple of episodes, and even get to use it against the Deepwater God. I have somewhat of doubts about that.
Moving now. Receiving. Moving now. Listening. Moving out.
Okay, what's in here? Ransack and strike. Let's just attack everything. Because why not? Oh. And max out. And you go on top because let's face it, we want you. You're here. Did I? First DD. Oh. You also should go up. But you can't spawn in right now. Oh. And I'm holding weapons. Didn't notice. Oh, that's. Might be ending up bad, but. Okay. And. This is already not looking the best. The first LCA only has laser munition over the side, so front on like that. That laser munition doesn't seem to work very well. Yeah. Yeah, just not reaching there. This may be a problem if you don't start to angle properly. And, well, it is killing that fortress there. Hmm. Maybe it lost its AI connection or something. No. Connection's still there. Huh. Now I'm confused. I mean, that was enough of an angle for the laser munition defense to activate. Yet it did not. Oh, it did. Is it just simply too weak? Yeah, it's simply too weak, it seems. Those shells too strong, guns too weak. Laser too weak. Meh. Yeah, you don't really need to shoot the more radar. Yeah, I know it's the biggest thing around, but it's this one, it's the dangerous one, so please kill it. And I don't think that the bigger gun is loaded. Well, it is. And it is, you know, firing, but missing half the time. Oh, okay, this thing is disabled, apparently. It's, where are the... Oh, they're just the Tweeties or whatever they're called. They're up there. And that one is too damaged, which is nice. We all have ignore salvage, yes. And, well, that's one. You don't look like taking much of any damage here. Huh. Hum, 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 hum. Well, missiles are hitting it, and they're doing quite considerable amount of damage to it. But everybody is going after this thing. I mean, even though, yeah, there is a moray inside of it, but this moray is inactive. It never launches. So, I have no idea why they're shooting at it so vigorously. Eh. is a bit odd. But okay, we are still doing damage to it, we are killing it slowly, and we will at some point kill it completely. Which gonna be pretty much still not gonna spawn anything, everything on my... We have like taken some damage, but I think that was either, yeah, ramming, either friendly fire, either getting themselves into an island position. Trying to become amphibious vehicles for some or other reasons. It kind of surprises me how much these ships can actually get themselves on top of islands, considering just how deep they're running into the water, you know, it's a bit funky. But, okay. I mean, we're killing it. Slowly. Okay, the Tweeties, I think they're dead. Yes, you. Yeah, you're the damage as well, so... Well, actually, there is one more Tweety over here. Hope you guys don't forget about it. Or completely forget about it. And this base is getting destroyed slowly. Seems like the missiles are not very willing to target this thing. They are rather going after something else. It could be that the ships got so close that missiles don't actually turn in time. Which could be the case. Alright. Now, come on. Well, you can't hit it from this distance, I'm pretty sure of that. I have no idea why it's... Yeah, behavior of our ship's AI is, well, a mystery to me. Of sorts. But okay. I mean, it's somewhat working at the moment. And another level. How many levels we're having now? God knows how many. No idea. And the first DD is, yeah, beach party. You're in search of fresh water. It's, no? I don't think you're gonna find it here. I'm... trying to make his own island nation, apparently, or something. Oh well, finally this thing is going out. So my ships should stop targeting it. Oh, the first CLCA is barely going around an island. Still scraping the bottom, yes, it is. And a couple of houses left. And then there is an entire fleet there. I know I ordered them. Or they are already dead. Did I miss that part of a fight completely? Could potentially be that has happened. 5-4. That's destroyed. You? Still standing up. Barely. Okay. Well, this one is going after the Tweety there. Hopefully missiles can hit, because guns are seems to not be that particularly effective. The AI does have some of the problems if the target is changing course rapidly. Like that, if it's making circles. Oh wait, no, this is the Shrike! Yeah! Oh! Wasn't there also a pilferer? Okay, I missed the fight with whatever there was. Well, we killed the Shrike. But I know there were like two things there, but... And... Well, one of them is apparently either completely dead, either. I think that the Falkenhan comes with the base. And there were two other things. That were in its individual opponent, but... Huh. Well, this is funky now. four, and let's get you regrouped here. Whoa. Lag. Actually, quite a lot of lag. That's not nice from you. And we should go and head this direction now. Out, back. What's here? Pedal gun, Antlion, and whatever that thing was. Is there anything to repair? No? Walrus, pedal gun prototype. We can go in a fight here. Yeah, you go up as well. We do want bigger ships to spawn in first. You're here? Yes. Something like this. It's gonna work just fine. It's okay. And
taking control.
And aren't you sea vehicle? Yeah. Oopsie, was designated as an aerial vehicle, so that could be somewhat embarrassing. And there comes the torpedoes already. AI dead! Wow, we like instant kill one. And the wolves taking quite a lot of damage up as well. And the paddle gun prototype, well, the second one. As the first one is, yes, they're all in combat. As the first one just AI deaded itself. Oh, two damaged on the Antlion. I think it's called like that. And yeah, this one is not looking very well either. Being pretty heavily bombarded there. Does have quite some missiles coming down. Minis may take some damage. But overall, it's okay. We are dealing just fine with this. It's the torpedoes that most likely gonna do more damage there than anything else. Only three of them? Really? Only three minis? Aren't there supposed to be four? Oh, we lost one. We lost the tiny. Oopsie. We lost the tiny. Well, they're not that expensive, we can rebuild them, no problem. And the walrus, it's, well, I have no idea, why is it putting these things in this campaign? I mean, I rarely saw them on easier difficulty, but they don't look like something that would be particularly dangerous in any aspect of the word dangerous. So this is gonna be a bit of a problem. Well, not problem, it's a bit odd, as I have no idea. What are you doing in a godly design mode? No idea, I don't have any either. I'm sorry, I'm just here. Okay. Yeah, we lost the tiny here. But it's paddle gun and paddle gun prototype. They're coming from the back. Pull. They were coming from the back. Should we wait for them? I mean, I don't wanna get my soup destroyed for some or other odd reasoning. Yeah, they're coming. Here we are rebuilt, so I think we can go up ahead and do this. And begin battle. Let's just finish this one quickly as possible. Ooh. And the paddle gun is taking a beating here. Ooh, and it exploded. It went boom. That's the way we won it. Yes. You're next. You're not surviving very well. Well, I mean, they have yet to target you properly, but you're not gonna survive for very long. At least I hope you are not going to, because there is no good reason for you to survive for very long. You're made out of wood. Yay. And torpedoes incoming as well, blowing chunks of this ship. I mean, it's taking some serious beating here. And more torpedoes, yeah. Ooh. And missiles, they're doing some work as well. And it's too damaged. Yay! Our overwhelming firepower pretty much dealt with this one. No problems whatsoever at all. Just nothing. And minis, yeah, repair. And pull all. And let's get going. We're gonna wanna use these two bases that are here and clean out some other stuff up as well. Oh, you guys already here? Yes, you are. Have you given the material to the fortress? Yes, you have. Okay. Oh, they're going like all the way around. Okay. Which one doesn't go there? Oh, it is. They're all going there. At least I'm thinking they're all going there. Hopefully not gonna get stuck in between the islands by the time the enemy attacks. Okay, we are not stuck in between the islands. And what do we have here? It's a paddle gun and a ratuna. Well, that's not exactly the most dangerous things that we could encounter. Yeah, let's just do it. Let's just go like that. Bit forward and let's start the battle. Okay, spawn everything else, because if we have the numbers, why not use them? Where are you? No. And missiles going out, and I don't think that the paddle gun will survive for long. Yeah, It just blew up. Too damaged. And the red tuna, it's not gonna be faring very well for very long. Yeah, one decent hit and it just explodes. And oh, missiles. All right, you repair and pull all. And let's go after this base here. We're gonna be having a lot of, I mean, we already have a lot of resources now. 18,000, 8, 10, 14, about 30,000, no, wait, 30,000, 40,000, that's quite a lot of resources. Maybe I should build like the first plane to transfer some of the resources back to base. And maybe building an egg or something to have like in between here and here. Alright, this is gonna be a land attack. Where are you? Oh, terrain's still spawning in. Oh, and it's one of these things which comes with this base, of course. Kind of defender of this base, but yeah, it's big guns but not very sturdy. Something of typical you know, deepwater god. And of course it gets, you know, AI dead already. And you will not survive for long either, because you're getting pummeled. Just, it's simple as that. Okay. You're getting hit fairly well. Yeps. We're not taking any damage, so that's nice. Okay, it's too damaged. We can start shooting now at something else. The main gun here is not loaded, it seems. But the rest of them are, so... We were not missing you all that much, main gun. Oh... The game can't from time to time like that. Just... Would seriously like it if out of the battle the guns would actually reload, because I don't think they are. I know that they didn't in the past. Now if they change anything, it could potentially be that they are, but I'm just too stupid to realize it. But I don't think that they do. It would be seriously nice, however, for them to do so, and... And, well, the house is destroyed. And, of course, the beach party. Yay. Okay, silence. Okay. Move forward. More battle. More... I don't know what. Alright, like that. And the soup, do please follow them. Don't want to leave you too far behind, as you have absolute no weaponry on board and you get caught up by something, we're gonna be regretting it. 16 out of 150. Ugh. I must say that the white flares, however, have reinforced their position pretty well up here. It's gonna be quite a bit of trouble fighting them. And I think I'm gonna need like a much larger fleet to go after them after we finish up with the Deepwater God. Okay, mini. Okay, attacking, and more attacking. And begin the battle. Let's crush the enemy. Oh, where the hell did you spawn in? And this is pretty much the base you started with the Onyx Watch campaign. If you start the Onyx Watch campaign, you get this base as your starting base. It does have a couple of flaws, like very easy to detonate it at the one side. And it's a general kind of not having actually a lot of firepower. And that's the Corsair there. You do know Corsair, if you annoy the ships too much, they're gonna start shooting you. And that, then you're not gonna be happy camper. Oh, you see? I told you so. Well, it was going after the first CLCA and... that thing has a bit too much of shielding for the Corsairs to be effective against them. The double layers of shielding doesn't only work against ship charge ammunition, it also works against stuff like flak, weaponry, or something like that. Too damaged, yes. This one is too damaged as well. We are pretty much won this battle. Oh! So we meet again, River Rat, look at you, you're gone and made yourself almost into a man. Got a bit of scruffing on your chin, you do, now I know what you'll be thinking. Thinking here's your chance to get your family home back and a bit of revenge while you're at it. But I must warn you, I have learned so much from those shiny technologies on that old boat that I apply them to my own prowler. You best just run along now if you know what's good for you. Eh? What about no? I better to say there is up north here is, I think a fleet smallish, yes, you see there, and one of them is this prowler there, you see, and there is also a wanderlust. That's the wanderlust you use in the training campaigns, I think they are. There is a whole set of like training missions and campaigns you can do, and you use this wanderlust quite a lot, and it kind of teaches you what you have to build and stuff in order to make your ships successful. And of course it's somewhat connects with this campaign up as well, so yay. But we're gonna of course nonchalantly attack it and wreck it, because it's not all that strong really. Wanderlust does have some defenses and laser munition defense and stuff like that, but the prowler itself doesn't actually have anything useful on it. It's just a standard prowler. And as the end result, it's gonna get smacked pretty hardcore. But as you can see, the Wanderlust here does have laser munition defense. Doesn't have any shielding, I mean, things. Yay. And, well, it's simply not gonna survive for long. We have taken the first CLCA that takes slightly bit of damage, but not that much. Would be actually a good idea to target the Wanderlust first for simply to disable its defenses, so it would be slightly less annoying shooting down our shells and stuff. And missiles. Oh! And there is a... I completely forgot, this is the Geiger thingy, or Geier, or what now, Gay. I can't remember what it is at the moment, something on a G and Geier, or something like that. It's just an awkward name that I cannot pronounce. But hooray, well, the Prowler is not looking its best, and the Wanderlust stopped using its laser munitions, so either that had been disabled, or it ran out of engine power. No engine still working on it. It's apparently just that the laser munition defense got disabled there. Yeah, taking too much damage. Yeah. And the big gun there, loaded, yes, it looks like, even though it's not, it doesn't seem to fire. Ooh. And the only one who is taking any damage are the minis there, most likely through ramming, and yeah, that's oh my god. You tiny fellows need to start to learn how to drive your vessels, for crying out loud. Oh well, the Prowler is too damaged now. It's just... it's a Prowler. One-on-one against one of the smaller ships, it may be dangerous, but in this sort of a fight, we have such an advantage over it. It's just... no. And you two are really, really trying to figure out who gonna win the humping competition. You just... you shouldn't be doing that. Get off! Ah, yeah. That just... rolling around and then bouncing back. Okay, that should allow you to get yourself free. Shouldn't you? Really? Alright. My own ship's protecting the enemy. Okay, it's finally too damaged up as well. But that was, yeah, you too. Bad ships. Bad ships, yes. I have no idea what the time is, so, you know, I'm gonna just kinda finish it off here and, well, hopefully we're somewhat on time, because I don't have an overlay for me unknown reasons. So, yeah, this is gonna be it. We have defeated the greatness of the great or something, and, well, see ya.